in Chandigarh called Sukhna Lake. It has a lot of tourist potential and recreational value. Lot of people from adjoining areas including Chandigarh come to see Sukhna Lake. But incidentally, what happened that after 15 years of its formation, one low rainfall year, it was suddenly realized that Sukhna Lake is silting at a very fast rate. And boys started playing cricket on the bed of the Sukhna Lake. Nobody bothered at the time of planning and constructing Sukhna Lake that the shivaliks are highly erodible, degraded, devoid of vegetation cover, and shivalik torrents are famous for their high velocity, lot of silt, and siltation of water bodies. We received message from New Delhi that you kindly visit the catchment areas of Sukhna Lake, see really what is happening and how it can be controlled. The lake is silting up at a very rapid rate. Mr. P.R. Mishra was in charge of the center at that time. I'm talking about 76-77. We started, walking from Sukhna Lake side down, up to see actually the areas from where the silt is coming. But as we started moving up and up, the vegetation density started decreasing and bare hill slopes started increasing. After some time, we saw large herds of cattle grazing. People of these villages were heavily dependent on, fuel, wood, fodder, grazing and this catchment area. Shivalik, this portion is really problematic in terms of erosion. And once the protective vegetation cover goes, these soils erode 30 times faster than other soil, normal soils. That is what happened in the upper areas. Vegetation was removed, very severe grazing, and as a result, a lot of sediments was coming from that. Those were the areas which are really contributing to the sedimentation of the Sukhna Lake. Then we started, normal way of plantation, put dry stone and create wire structures, make trenches, make plantation of hair trees, put some grasses. That was the routine, way of doing it. And we covered about 80 hectares, most difficult area near Sukhumajre. But we suddenly, after doing the work, we realized that the laborers who were working with us during the daytime, their families and their cows and, they are grazing in the area which we feel that we have planted. And Mr. Mishra, a very old, dedicated forester, he realized that the problem is not in the forest, the problem is in the village. Gaon mein problem hai. Gaon mein problem, he meant that we will have to motivate people to join hands and then stop grazing. We will have to find out alternatives for them.
But when we had a meeting with all the farmers, they told very clearly that you are just trying to save your lake in Chandigarh. You are not doing anything for us. Then why we should cooperate? And when we inquired that what were the main constraints with their farming and all, they said very clearly, we have got only rain-fed farming. We don't have actually any provision for the water here. And ultimately, sometimes crop failures are there. And many a time they get very low yield. So that was the main issue.
When their crops fail, frequently fail, then they tend to supplement their income by keeping a lot of livestock. That is the second alternative. When they keep a lot of livestock and there is no sufficient fodder for them, wherever they are adjoining forest areas, they are used as, open, grazing grounds. Goats and cows. Goats, large number of goats were there in Sukhumajri.
सारे लोग बकरी और गाय थी तो उन्होंने कहा भी आप बकरी गाय बेच दो हमारी गल जुड़ो भी, हमारी गल काम कराओ। सर आप तो बड़े आदमी हैं, हमारे को तो, हम तो जिम्मेदार लोग हैं, हमारे तो जो बारिश है उस पर, मतलब बारिश पर दाना पक्का होता है हमारे तो। उन्होंने कहा भी आपका जो मंगेंगे वो देंगे हम।
We found that a pool of water is there. It is the month of October and people were preparing to sow wheat crop. I suggested Mr. Mishra that this pool of water, if we irrigate the lands down below with sprinklers, probably that may will make a lot of difference because it has become difficult to sow crops, you know, the surface layer was dry. He jumped over the idea. That was the first revolution, I will say, that villagers realized that this water could be used for irrigation, which they never thought. One of the farmer, Daulatram, told Dr. Bhamla, sir, this is very, very small. We have another place where a big dam can be constructed and our entire village can get water. Why don't you see the site and then construct another dam? It's a good site. We surveyed and got the approval of the second dam, which was the main dam.
उन्होंने हमारे गांव में चार डैम लगाए, जैसे नंबर एक, नंबर दो, नंबर तीन, नंबर चार, ऐसे चार डैम लगाए और उनसे एक पाइपलाइन लगा के यहां गांव के मतलब 75 एकड़ जमीन को पानी मिलना शुरू हो गया।
They could see that this water will change their life. Immediately, you know, on the persuasion of Mr. Mishra, they constituted their own, you know, committee, Hill Resource Management Committee, and themselves decided that anybody whose, you know, cow goes for grazing, we will fine him 5 rupees per animal. Then any goat, you know, 2 rupees, they decided. Water will not be given free. We will charge 2 rupees per hour for water. And this money will go to the cess fund for maintenance. So this motivated people not to take animal. वो अपनी लैंग्वेज में दुड़ जाता है, दे यूज टू इट, सिल्ट भर जाएगी इसमें, झील में सिल्ट भर गया तो पानी कहाँ से लोगे, पानी से तो जिंदगी बन जाएगी, भैया जानवर मत लेके जाओ हमें। सो दैट वॉज द मैसेज। सेकेंड ईयर वी सॉ ए ड्रामेटिक चेंज दैट काउज वर रिप्लेस्ड बाई बुफेलो, गोट्स वर सोल्ड, सम पीपल सोल्ड गोट्स टू गेट देयर लैंड लेवल्ड।
हमारा जो मतलब जमीन थी ना सर, ऊँट की पीठ थी, ऊँट पर दे पानी घिसर जाता तो हमारा पानी बाहर निकल जाता था। अब हमारा जिस दिन से मिश्रा जी ने हमारे को पानी दिया, उस दिन से हमारी जमीन हमने मतलब ट्रैक्टर गैल क्या काफ़ी मशीन गैल एक सार कर ली, हूँ हमारी जमीन एक प्लेन है, ऊँट की पीठ से हम प्लेन हो गई।
हिल्स आर प्रोटेक्टेड, वाटर इज रेंज, पीपल द इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन ऑफ द पीपल इम्प्रूव्स, दे गेट यू नो मोर मिल्क, and then barseem crop made a very big revolution because barseem require irrigation, it is a green fodder, and when barseem comes, buffalo comes, when buffalo comes, then milk comes, when milk comes, then money comes in the hands of women, and then daily income instead of crops, which income gets after 6 months.
हमारे टाइम में मछली पालन का भी काम चालू हो गया, उससे भी मतलब संस्था को हमारी को इनकम हो गई, और जैसे फसलें गेहूं की है या गन्ने की है या कपास बाड़ी जो भी है ना, इनमें पानी लगने की वजह से इनका उत्पादन मतलब 50% उत्पादन बढ़ गया जी हमारे।
बट बिग चेंज वॉज दैट ऑल ऑफ देम स्टार्टेड एजुकेटिंग देयर चिल्ड्रन, दे हैड मनी, सो गर्ल्स स्टार्टेड गोइंग टू द स्कूल्स। वी हैव फोटोग्राफ्स, यू नो, व्हेन वी स्टार्टेड विद सुखम बाजरी, हाफ ऑफ द बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स हैड नो शूज, मैनी ऑफ देम हैड, बच्चों के no shirt and the small, you know, pant phata hua, but then after 7-8 years we noted uniform pehen ke tie laga ke english they going to english schools, very big change, you know, took place.
Nahi hamare pe gaon mein sab pe jhopdi thi, sab pe har ek ghar mein ek ek jhopdi thi, matlab ab har ek us gaon mein ja ke dekho pakke makan hai ji aur koi matlab kachcha makan nahi hai। हर एक के पास हर एक संदाजी मशीनरी ते मोटर भी है, गाड़ी भी है सबके पास।
ICR इंडियन काउंसिल ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर रिसर्च एंड होम द सुकुमाली प्रोजेक्ट वाज गोइंग ऑन टुक ए रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू रेप्लिकेट इन 48 नेशनल वाटरशेड्स। देन दिस इंटीग्रेटेड वाटरशेड मैनेजमेंट प्रोग्राम केम विच वाज फंडेड बाय द वर्ल्ड बैंक इन नॉर्थ इंडिया एंड 5 स्टेट्स and also NWDPR, National Watershed Development Project for Rainfed Area, they were basically on the pattern of Sukumadri.
I think it's a very important model because this was all the work was done first time in the participating mode, and this was then actually replicated in the state of Punjab, Haryana, Himachal and J&K. And you will surprise that in the whole of the country, now whatever watershed program is being done are being taken up by the State Department, by the central government department, by the NGOs, it's all being taken in the participatory mode. So that was the first lesson we got from the Sukhumajri watershed.
Lakhs and lakhs of territories have come up, which there was hardly any. Even our studies, you know, showed that 10 times increase in the territories. And since there is a ban on green filling, if you look at the top, the bottoms, you will fill all filled with trees. Now the sediment, earlier whatever sediment was detached from the slope was going right into Sukhna Lake. But now there is so much of trees, grasses, bushes and structures on way. The gullies have been filled up, they have been flat lands down below, and on that lot of care has come. The value of those trees which have come out of the production, it will run into crores of rupees.
Initially, we had a joint forest management, JFM. But afterward, there were some changes actually in the policy of the Haryana state regarding JFM. And these farmers, they were getting less share. So that was one of the issues. Secondly, there was bhabha grass was there earlier, which were being sold to actually Jagadari factory for making the paper. But afterward, those actually factory in Jagadari, they have changed the technique and they were not using the bhabha grass for making the paper. So ultimately, the prices of the bhabha grass, they fell down like anything. So they were not getting any much of the profit. So when the policy change was there in JFM, at the same time, they were not getting good price for the bhabha grass. So ultimately, there was, yes, I think there was a lot of resentment, I think, by the farmers.
Actually, this whole belt of Paddi and Panjaur area, having come under industrial, influence, so people started buying land, in this area. And Hooghda has carved out a small colony also there in Sukhumajri.
Because Sukhumajri is quite close to the urban areas, so now they are going to construct some road also in the Sukhumajri watershed. The first thing is, I think the agriculture land will be lost. Because once they make a road, some of the agriculture fields, the farmers have to sell. So whatever natural resource management model we have, then I think this won't be there.
डैम का पानी लग रहा है, 6-7 साल हो गए कोई डैम का पानी लग रहा है। हमारी ये जमीन एक्वायर होगी ना सर, खेती खत्म होगी, मतलब ये होगी सारी 200-300 बीघे जमीन रहेगी सारी।
Villagers have lost that type of interest because now they are selling land from here and buying somewhere else, other places. And they have alternate source of water in terms of that irrigation from the two wells it is coming.
जिस दिन से हमारे डैम लगे, हमारा वाटर लेवल था 400 पर, 400 पर थे हमारा वाटर लेवल 185 पर आ गया। अब डैम हमारे ट्यूबवेल 6-7 ट्यूबवेल गांव में लगे हुए हैं।
Sukhumajri is still valid. Sukhumajri model is required in whole of the Himalayas to reduce the silt loads of these reservoirs. People remember Sukhumajri as a concept, not as a single model.